Ladies and gentlemen of Revolution, thank you so much for joining me. Today, I have the great pleasure of speaking to a living legend and an icon, Mr. Kikuo Ibe, the creator of the Casio G-Shock, a man who actually needs no introduction, but allow me to introduce him nonetheless. So, for everyone out there, everyone that is a G-Shock fan, everyone whose life has been changed by the G-Shock, many people who are having it as their first watch, having it as a watch as one of the watches that's created a collection for them, one of the watches that makes them dream for the future, please let me say a big, warm, happy hello to Mr. Kikuo Ibe. How are you, sir?
Today, I'm glad to speak with Mr. Ueko. It's unfortunate that I could not see you in Singapore. However, I was looking forward to seeing you through Zoom. Let's get started.
Excellent. But Mr. Ibe, if you don't mind, before we start the interview, can I ask you two questions? So question number one was, when was the last time you were in Singapore? And question number two is, what do you enjoy the most about your time in Singapore?
Number one, I visited Singapore 2 years ago in 2019. I remember that young people were having fun for walking on Orchard Road. And for lunch, I had a bak choy, and for dinner, I had chili crab. It made me very happy. And I'm looking forward to the day when I can go to Singapore soon.
Ibe-san, when you were in Singapore, what was one of the most interesting questions a Singaporean fan asked you? And what was your reply to this question?
A few years ago, one of young G-Shock fans asked you, I want you to stay in Singapore all the time. What should I do? I answered, I booked a cheap flight ticket, which was unable to change flight date. Next time, I will request our company to buy more expensive ticket, which enable me to change a flight date. Then he was laughing. He was very friendly and gave me such a kind question.
Excellent. Ibe-san, when you were developing the G-Shock ahead of its launch in 1983, you had devised something called the Triple 10 Principle. This was to guide you. Could you tell us a little bit about how you went about formulating the Triple 10 Principle and what did it entail?
Over half a year after having kick-off experiments, at that time when two new members joined in the team, we decided to put up a slogan. As I had a dropping experiment from 10 meter height, the new slogan Triple 10 consisted of 10 meter free fall endurance, 10 bar water resistance, 10 year battery life was coined. Eventually, the actual product reached shock resistance, 20 bar water resistance, and 7 year battery life.
Ibe-san, when you recount the story of the G-Shock, you often speak about the challenges of the formula of the resin that you ultimately decided on for the DW5000. But why is it that the color of the watch that you ultimately settled on was black?
From the standpoint of safety and security, urethane was selected despite of its difficulty in forming. Eventually, engineers' master craftsmanship resolved issues in forming. To emphasize strength, black color was chosen. At that time of development, it was a mainstream trend that the thinner or the smaller watches were, the higher they were rated. Black color may have played a role to make users feel big and thick watches smaller than they factually were.
That's absolutely fascinating. I love that. So, Ibe-san, could you tell us about the first time that the G-Shock was produced in color back in 1992, and then how it became a big phenomenon thanks to a suggestion made by Mr. Shigenori Ito, better known as Mr. G-Shock?
Yellow coloring was demanded by US Casio originally, which used to be greatly popular as sports car color. In 1992, Yellow DW5600 was the first emergence of colored G-Shock. Later on in 1994, our designers introduced the new concept capsulate toughness with DW001. This model featured separate coloring on the bezel and the back cover, where innovative coloring combination yellow and red was invented. After that, in 1997, we could successfully have more variety in coloring with Mr. Ito's proposals.
This is really interesting. So, Ibe-san, could you tell us also about the first collaborative G-Shocks? The first one, I think, was with Stussy, and then followed shortly after with A Bathing Ape by Nigo.
As renowned street fashion brands such as Stussy or Bathing Ape acknowledged G-Shock influence, Casio could collaborate to develop one of the famous models, DW6900. We printed brand logos, changed colors letter by letter, and made pictures pop out with EL backlight. Collaboration brought many novel approaches. We fully appreciate that collaboration led us to successive chance later to launch various collaborative products.
So interesting. So, Ibe-san, can I ask you, how did it make you feel to realize that the G-Shock, which was designed as a utilitarian watch, was evolving, becoming a luxury watch with a greater reliance on street culture and a way of people expressing themselves?
Truth be told, it was simply surprising, since G-Shock was initially developed primarily for workers of road construction. With evolution of style and colors, I believe that G-Shock has fitted in the expression of young generation's personality. Especially, it is my honor that young Singaporeans also widely accept G-Shock. Thank you very much.
I would say they don't accept, they love G-Shock. So, Ibe-san, can I ask you another question?
Yes.
When the G-Shock first shed its skin, it's in 1996 made from resin and became all metal with the all steel MRG100 and the all titanium MRG100T. How did it feel seeing these G-Shocks in metal? Could you tell us about how these incredible watches came about?
In 1990s, by finding that consumer segments get broader to even younger generation, it was imperative to launch full metal product to keep them as fans of G-Shock even while getting older. To make it happen, we embarked on the project in 1994 and brought the product into the market in 1996. I believe that the new metal product should have contributed to expand consumer segments with joys of more selections in showcase.
I'm wearing my all titanium G-Shock. This is a fantastic watch.
Very good.
Thank you. So let me ask you, in the context of contemporary G-Shock and its various families, color, material, and finish has all become defining factors of the identity, to the point that it is now considered a formal aspect of G-Shock identity as CMF. What are your thoughts on these factors being used to grow the G-Shock's identity?
CMF is representing for color, material, finish is a root concept of G-Shock, which always pursues for coloring, development of materials, and finishing of printing or coating. CMS has indefinite potential to contribute to further evolution of G-Shock. Please expect with CMF, G-Shock will become the more enjoyable and interesting.
That's fantastic. You know, what's so interesting is that for a watch that was born as a robust black watch in resin, I mean, it's so interesting to see the colors of being applied to G-Shock. What does this mean to you in contemporary G-Shock to see these colors?
users may enjoy G-Shock depending on their modes. I myself seasonally switch black, red, and white watches. Colors are significant to humans. I kind of daydream that it would be fun if there was a watch to keep changing its colors by reading our daily modes.
Amazing. Now, next question, and this is related to the watch I'm wearing on my wrist. For a watch that was born as a robust watch in resin, what does it mean to you to see novel materials applied to G-Shock, such as titanium and even carbon? We understand that there was a short time when you were considering producing a contemporary sapphire G-Shock. Is that true?
At the inception of development, only black urethane resin were practically available to manufacture watches. With continuous research and development, new and various materials keep rolling out. We actively look for the materials making watches tougher. I expect more and more materials will become available with technological advancement. I have longed for dreaming materials which might be solid like iron, but with gentle texture and cool in summer, but warm in winter.
Amazing. Ibe-san, let me ask you of the application of CMF to metals, that so many things are possible. If I look now at the camouflage coating that's applied to the GMW 8B500TCM-1DR, or the aged IP that's applied to the GMW 8500V, or more recently, the incredible finish that's applied to the Blue Phoenix MTG B2000PH. Tell us about these coatings and what it means to you.
Application of CMF to metals made it possible. Whereas traditional metal colors used to be limited to either silver, gold, or black, application of CMF to metals expanded possibilities infinitely. CMF expanded joys to wrap metal products around our wrist.
Amazing. Ibe-san, one of the coolest watches from this year is the Mr. G Hana Basara, which is such an interesting project in that it is combining titanium but with the watch bezel in cobarium, which has been polished and finished like a precious jewel by Mr. Kazuhito Komatsu. What are your thoughts on the paradox of having the world's toughest watch decorated using jewel finishing techniques?
Fusion of technological advancement and traditional techniques is the fundamental concept of MRG. This model literally materializes the concept. Various traditional techniques are spotted all over Japan. Casio seeks for more fusions of technological advancement and traditional techniques, which should fascinate Singaporeans.
Excellent. And you know, Ibe-san, the last time we spoke, you told us of your alien friend. I believe his name was Taro. And about wearing your G-Shock watches in space as being one of your greatest dreams for G-Shock. Now, using the concept of CMF, what do you think Taro's watch would look like?
Thank you for remembering the story. The environment in the space is unimaginably harsher than the Earth, as even the temperature may spike up and down to an extreme degree. Following the common sense would ruin all electronic components inside watches. It would be necessary to come up with an extraordinary idea, like a watch automatically let itself cool down in the heaty environment in the space, or vice versa. To protect those components, let me ask my alien friend Taro-kun, tonight, how styles, colors, or patterns of watches are supposed to be. I'm looking forward to passing down Taro-kun's opinions onto you the next time when I visit Singapore. Thank you for having me today.
Thank you, Ibe-san. The pleasure was entirely ours. It was a great honor and a great pleasure.
This time, also there were very interesting questions. I really appreciate that Mr. Weiko has researching about G-Shock a lot. I'm really looking forward to seeing you soon in Singapore. Also, I'm looking forward to seeing everyone in Singapore next time. Thank you for having me today. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was a great pleasure.